There was a musicologist, whose name I forget, who, when they were putting the music on the Voyager Golden Record, said, well, we should just put all of Bach on it, nothing else. And then he thought about that and thought, well, actually, that would just be showing off. I think as long as human beings have looked up in the sky and seen the planets and seen these pinpricks of light, we have wondered what they are and what they mean and what our significance and where we fit into the jigsaw puzzle. And absolutely, when we think about classical music, of course, we generally automatically go to Holst the planets, but people like Beethoven, people like Bach were also considering this question. Beethoven famously remarked in one of his diaries, what will my listeners think of my music on Saturn? What will they think of it on Venus? You know, they were thinking exactly these kind of questions. And actually something like the famous Voyager Golden Records that were sent out into space in the late 1970s kind of went to a certain extent to answer that question, because Bach and Beethoven are both on that record and have now been sent out into the interstellar medium, the space between the stars outside our solar system. And out there, of course, they will not decay, they will not rot, they will outlast planet Earth forever. Maybe one day somebody will find them, like in Star Trek, Next Generation. One would hope aliens would like Bach's music. When we think about music, music is one of those things that is common to all human cultures across all of time. And I think people still regard Bach as, well, depending on who you are, of course, as really the kind of the best of us. So if you did want to send a message to aliens, then I guess Bach is as good as we've got. What they'd make of it, of course, is anyone's guess. But even considering that question is a great question, because it reflects, of course, back on us, and it's about what we think about ourselves and our music. 1977, when the Voyager spacecrafts were launched, was a great year for popular culture, of course. It was the year that Elvis Presley died. It was the year that Star Wars came out. Charles and Ray Eames' famous short film Powers of Ten that examined our place in the cosmos. But also my particular favourite film was Spielberg's Close Encounters, because suddenly here was almost like a documentary about how we would communicate with aliens. And of course, like the Golden Records themselves, it was music that was deemed the best language, a kind of universal language, like the universal laws of physics. And it was beautifully encapsulated by those five notes. Do, 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 do. One of the things about human beings is that, of course, we're aware of our own mortality. We like to communicate. We think about the planets and we think about the stars, and naturally we think about other civilizations that might be out there. And of course, you look at the history of exploration on Earth, it's always been about crossing horizons and coming into contact with new cultures and sharing common things like language. And so this idea of sending messages in bottles into space carries on. It has a long tradition, and of course we see people like Elon Musk sending his red Tesla sports car into space, whatever you think of that. Of course it's got the David Bowie song constantly on a loop playing as it orbits around Mars. So this is a long tradition that we will keep on doing, sending ourselves out into the stars. What would I send? It changes daily. Like if it was today, I'd put in Blues Run the Game by Jackson C. Frank. That's just because that's what I was listening to at breakfast. But tomorrow it'll be something else.